Congratulations, guys, on Buddy Games. I watched it and laughed and groaned, you know, in equal measure. So I think you did exactly what you needed to. Yeah. Josh, this was your first time directing and writing, right?
Yes.
What was the genesis of that experiment? How did we get here?
Well, an experiment is probably a good word. It was something I'd written stuff before, but never actually written like a full, you know, anything that had been done. I'd write ideas and I'd normally just give it to a screenwriter to go finish it. I worked with Jude Wang, who was awesome throughout the process, who really kind of helped me structure this thing. But, you know, I just really, truly wanted to make a movie that, you know, I guess I'm a bit of a contrarian by nature. I like to sort of go against the grain and push things as far as I can and see what happens. And those are the kind of movies that I love. I love the Farrelly Brothers, Something About Mary, Dumb and Dumber. I love Todd Phillips. I love Judd Apatow. These movies, to me, are the ones that people remember. And I really wanted there to be moments in this thing that people would go, I cannot believe they actually showed that. and so that was what we wanted. But we also wanted to make a movie that was grounded, and it is grounded. You know, despite all of the hijinks and all the crazy debauchery, there's a real group of friends there that would do anything for each other. And, you know, this movie's about a guy who's down and out because of something that went bad because of these guys years ago. And, you know, they feel obligated to this guy to bring him back, you know, no man left behind. And that's where I think Dan did such a beautiful job of playing that character.
Yeah. Speaking of that grounded side of Shelley, he's been through a lot when the movie starts. How do you kind of pull A, the human side of his character with the hijinks, and then B, the strength of a friendship that would survive something like that?
Dan, take like that one, would you? Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think for me, what I did was I just approached it. I came from a Second City in Chicago background. And the first thing they taught me there was, let's not go for comedy. Let's go for believable first. And then let the audience tell you where the comedy is. This section's going to laugh at this. That section's going to laugh at this. Everyone's going to laugh at this. And you just let them decide what's funny. And there was a moment when preparing for my favorite scene in the film is when Josh and I are in the ward, when he comes to get me, rescue me from the hospital. And I sat for a long, 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 long time with earphones on, just listening to sad music, trying to kind of get in the mindset of, you know, I'm at the end of my rope and let's not concentrate on comedy. I hope there's funny moments in this scene. I hope I don't ruin Josh's script and take away all the comedy, but let's concentrate on how broken this person is right now and then let the comedy come wherever it is.
This is why I love this
Josh
guy.
Wrote script.
This is why I love Dan, because he is an actor first. He truly is a gifted actor. And that's really what I wanted, was guys who weren't necessarily just comedians, but actors. I mean, look at Dan. He's one of the most real dudes you'll ever meet. And that comes across in the film. He's a guy who just, you believe that he has really been through this. And I wanted him to go there first to really, you believe this guy has really at the end of his rope. I mean, he's on suicide watch in this psych ward / drug rehab hospital, whatever that was. And
yeah.
we needed to believe that, you know, we needed to believe it couldn't just be a guy who was just sort of like clownish. That we needed a real grounded actor. And that's what we got. We're so blessed to get Dan. And he was the last one we cast. This character that he played,
really?
His character was the last one we cast because we needed to get it right. We needed somebody who had some, you know, some gravity to him.
He absolutely did. Because I definitely was like, really felt bad for Shelley. I was like, oh my God. But on the lighter side, in real life, who would win the buddy games, right? You guys are really competitive with each other. Oh, and of course,
I would.
Josh.
Josh. Well, no, you're supposed to say you. You're supposed to say you, Dan.
No, I'll say me. You.
So it wouldn't even be, just be like, we'd all just give up early so that.
It's not true, believe me. I've only won, the real ones, I think I've only won once in 20 years, so.
Oh, wow.
But if it was between the people that played in the movie, it would be you or Dax every year, guaranteed.
Well, I would love to actually witness the real life version, but thank you guys so much. It was really fun time watching the movie, and great job, Josh and Dan.
Thank you so much, Tatiana.
Bye.
You're always welcome, by the way. You can come next year.
Thank you. I will join. I will win.